up, YouTube? It's your boy, Riku the Best, better than the rest, aka the Dark Knight. You call me that, you good for today. Coming at you with another Dragon Ball Legends discussion video. We're going to be talking about the top 5 units with the highest strike damage in the game, overall strike damage, for this meta, during this meta, because it's going to constantly change. Like I said, when they come out new banners, new units will have a chance to be on my top 5 list for whatever stat it may be. Social media is going to be at the top. If you have any of those platforms, you know what to do. And before I start off naming the top 5, before I start with the order, I want to throw a little disclaimer, okay? This is going to only factor in Z ability level 1. So when you first pull the unit, Z ability level 1, no equipment. Only this unit and this unit abilities alone. If the unit abilities require to have another unit, that will be factored in the highest overall damage output strike-wise for that character. If that unit requires another unit to get certain boosts, that will be required. However, it has to be that unit and not the team buffing them with their abilities. The unit abilities only. And every unit is going to be put in the best situation possible. So for example, if I'm talking about these units, it's going to be versus type advantage in the best possible scenarios, depending on their ability. Remember how we deal with Turles? Although his key card gives them a random ability of blast attack up or strike damage up or a key recovery up, basically that type of thing. Even if it's a randomized numerical value, I would still give them that highest buff or whatever stat I'm talking about. So for Raditz, I did apply that 30% buff blast damage from his key card. So we got that out the way. Without further ado, number 5, Super Saiyan 2 Kid Gohan. Yeah, he has a base strike attack of 41,960, and his main ability, he draws a super art card or ultimate art card, does not factor in. However, his unique ability, 15% to own strike damage inflicted for each down character. So it's going to be 15%, another 15%, taking into consideration he's in the best situation possible. Two people are dead, that's 30% buff to his strike damage. And with him, his other unique ability, with him being under 50% HP, he's going to get 50% damage inflicted. So 15%, 15%, 50%, plus the 10% to impact damage received. Now, you have to be careful with this because not every unit has the impact. I'll put it up on the screen for Gohan. Not every unit has the impact with the strike card. The blue Frieza, the blue range Frieza, Space Power Frieza, has Pyrrhus for his strike cards. I believe it's Pyrrhus. It's not going to be impact for everybody. Double check that. For Yamcha, I believe it's like Slash or something like that. So yeah, it's not going to be impact for everybody. It's common, but not just for everybody. So yeah, that's going to be factored in as well. 15%, 15%, 50%, and then 10%, as well as the 15% from his key card, just damage inflicted in general, key blast wise, melee wise. That's going to be factored in as well as his Z ability. Z ability 1, 19% to Hybrid Saiyan strike attack. With all that factored in, he is, and all that included, and his overall melee damage, he's going to be the number 5 highest melee unit in the game overall this meta. So number 4, Yellow Gohan still remains to keep his spot on this list. I remember doing the list before. He was like 1 or 2. No, I think it was, no, he's actually number 1. I still can't find that damn list. So he's going to have a base strike of 42.14. All right. So his main ability off the bat gives him 50% to strike damage. His unique ability, now this is the tricky part, not really. His unique ability, the 20% buff, only applies when there are 3 people left. However, his other unique ability only applies when Piccolo is dead. When one unit dies, he's not going to get that double team strike attack buff. So we're not going to add the 20% because, like I said, the best scenario for that unit. So we're going to assume that Piccolo is dead on your team, which means you won't have all 3 available to use, including himself. So with Piccolo dying, we're going to have the 50% from his main ability, 35% from his unique ability, the 20% from his Maseiko, his super art card effect, his key card gives him 20% to strike and blast, and his, that's it, his Z ability is actually for HP. So with his 50%, 35%, 20%, and 20% yet again, all included with his overall melee damage, puts him above Super Saiyan 2 Kid Gohan. So going into the number 3 spot, Bardock still remains to be on this list, but why is Bardock only number 3? I'll gladly show you why. Bardock base strike attack 41.01. All right, Main ability gives him 40% to strike damage. So that's 40%. His unique ability gives him 30% inflicted when two allies are down. So when two people are dead, he will get 30%. So 40%, 30%, 35 for each downed member. So 40%, 30%, 35%, another 35%. And his Z ability gives 19% to strike attack. So with his 40%, 30%, 35, 35, and his 19% gives him the number 3 spot on this list for the highest overall melee damage in the game, this meta. It will change continuously every meta, of course. So number 2, we have Super Trunks. His base strike, probably like the second highest base strike in the game, 45.56, all right? So his main ability is 75% to strike damage. That's already insane right there. 75% to strike damage with his main ability. His unique ability, 20% to strike damage received. So as soon as he switch in, they will be debuffed as far as strike defense. So that's really the same as him getting an extra 20% towards him, because as soon as he come in, they'll be receiving 20% more strike damage. So 75%, 25%, you have his 10% from his Buster Cannon effect. You also have a 15% from his key card effect, as well as a 19% from his strike attack. Well, not from his strike attack, from his Z ability for his strike attack in critical. Critical we don't factor in for melee damage. So with that included all for this character, he is in the number 2 spot. So that makes you think, who the hell is in a number 1 spot? I'll gladly show you. Super Saiyan, my boy Goten, how you doing? 44.12 for a base strike attack. And let's check out this. Now, the funny part about this, with his main ability, I only factored in his main ability throwing out one key card. So you know how his main ability works. The more key cards you have in your hand, you use the main ability to draw another card. That card will be powered up by the amount of key cards you discard it. You know, you discard it. So I only factored in the 50%, the one key blast card to discard to grab a melee. However, this is also chancy, like Turles key card, you know, because you may not always draw a melee card from your main ability. You can also get a key card by discarding a key card. So that's why I said, in the best case scenario, in the best situation possible for this character, dishing out only one card for 50% to get a melee card. That will be powered up by 50%. So his unique ability, he gets 40% to strike while having Trunks on the team, 20% to strike for 30 seconds. So he gets the 50%, the 40%, the 20%, the 15% from his Kamehameha, the 10% also from his key card, as well as the 17% from his Z ability. So if I were to factor in him dishing out the most cards he could have, 4 cards, and draw a melee card, he would be far beyond anybody in the game melee damage wise. He really would. It'll only be powered up for that one card, but that one card can make a big difference. So that is my list. As I said, I only factored in Z ability level 1, the character's best case scenario. In certain situations, yes, Gohan, Super Saiyan 2 Gohan can out damage like Bardock. Other situations, you know, Goten can be out damaged by Super Trunks, etc., etc., so on and so forth. It's just the highest damage output they can possibly, you know, do in the best case scenario for them. That's how it is. That's how I factor all this stuff. Of course, I added all the percentages to the base stat instead of stacking onto it after I added percentages. So I don't add, like, if I add 15% to it, a 44.12, whatever that amount I get, I don't add the next percentage that I add all the percentages to the base strike attack. That's how it come with the overall strike attack. If you guys want to see the values, I actually have it. So, Super Saiyan Goten, 111.16 is the overall value for him. Not disregarding the 4 cards that he can discard and grab a melee card. If I factored in Goten discarding 4 Ki Blast cards, he would have a total value of 177,000.34. Trunks, Super Trunks is sitting at 108,000.87. Bardock is sitting at 106.20. Kid Gohan Yellow is sitting at 94.79. Super Saiyan 2 Kid Gohan is sitting at 93.97. Thank you guys for watching. Let me know what you guys think in the comment box below. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video. That's going to be it for this. Jenna, bye!